Will asteroid Apophis hit Earth in 2029? What are your plans for 2029? According to scientists, a potentially hazardous asteroid named Apophis will be directed towards the Earth. Whether you believe in science or not, this is no joke. Every newspaper is talking about it. April 13th, 2029. Save the date. This is when it will be visible from Europe and Africa. Forget about all the plans you've made and get some tickets for you and your loved ones. Even though Apophis will not end up destroying the Earth, this will be the event of a lifetime. Keep watching the video to get to know more about it. Let's go. Chelyabinsk event. It's 2013 in the Russian city of Chelyabinsk. The teacher, Yulia Karbysheva, is ordering her students to stay away from the room's windows and hide under the desks. If anyone in the scientific community had predicted the impact of the asteroid, a simple warning to the entire population could have reduced the number of people hurt in Chelyabinsk. A blast came and Yulia found herself lacerated. A window glass cut through her arm, severing a tendon. Thankfully, none of her students got hurt. At any point in time, our planet could get hit by a piece of rock and metal. Most of these objects don't constitute a threat, and the closest to approach is usually the small ones. Yet we need to develop instruments that allow for both space surveillance and predictions of a potential impact of an asteroid, and a population warning system that will save lives and reduce injuries. And we need to do this also because in 2029, when the Earth-grazing asteroid Apophis will come our way. The closest approach. The moment Apophis will be the closest to Earth, it will fly by at a distance of about 20,000 miles away from the Earth's surface. This is basically 1/10 of the Earth-Moon distance. Yet when scientists discovered it in 2004, it was no more than a tiny dot swimming in a sea of stars. It's estimated to be about 1,100 feet or 340 meters across, and it was soon identified as one of the most hazardous asteroids that could impact Earth. Thankfully, that impact assessment changed after astronomers tracked Apophis and its orbit became better determined. Not only that, the fast technology changes of the last decades allowed for a radar observation campaign that showed Apophis won't impact the Earth for at least a century. You can relax then. And this could be the end of this video. But what if I told you there is so much more to it? Let me tell you what will happen in 5 years when Apophis will be visible to the naked eye from both Europe and Africa. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The event. Since you could see it with your own eyes, you wouldn't want to miss the event. So have you already decided to plan a vacation to Africa or Europe? You'll probably be flirting with that guy or girl you've always been in love with, and the one under the stars could be the perfect date for you too, as you watch the movie of the universe while its film develops under your astonished eyes. Or maybe you'll have kids and you would want to take them by the sea, their jaws dropped, and at that exact moment you'll know you'll be awarded the best mom and dad prize of the year. Or you'll be enjoying some quality alone time and there will only be you, the night sky, and the flying dot, Apophis. You will feel lucky because you know you're safe on your planet. However, it doesn't matter how spectacular and satisfying the sight of this asteroid will be. If you didn't know anything else about it, you won't be able to distinguish it from an alien or some sort of orbiting object such as an artificial satellite. That's why astronomical observations are useful, to characterize the objects in the sky. Even though Apophis has no atmosphere, no magnetosphere, and no rings or moons, it's still useful to study its structure, composition, and formation. This will in turn be some added value when we get to observe it with the naked eye. Structure and composition. Apophis is classified as an S-type or stony-type asteroid made up of silicate or rocky materials and a mixture of metallic nickel and iron. Radar images suggest it is elongated and possibly has two lobes, making it look something like a peanut. Much more will be learned about this asteroid's structure following its close flyby of Earth in 2029. And here's something really interesting. Knowing well the composition and distribution of the internal mass of the asteroid will help us understand the history of the solar system, but it would also be extremely useful information in case we need to eliminate it. Knowing in depth what the structure is, in fact, fundamental to better choose the weapon to use to deflect or destroy it. Formation history. Like all asteroids, Apophis is a remnant from the early formation of our solar system about 4.6 billion years ago. It originated in the main asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. Over millions of years, its orbit was changed primarily by the gravitational influence of large planets like Jupiter, so that it now orbits the Sun closer to Earth. As a result, Apophis is classified as a near-Earth asteroid as opposed to a main belt asteroid. Knowing we are observing an object of 1,100 feet made of nickel and iron and formed 4.6 billion years ago is what adds an incredible value to our naked eye observations, which suddenly become even more interesting. By observing it moving fast in the night sky, we're actually witnessing part of our own history, the history of the solar system. OSIRIS-REx and Apophis. Perhaps one of the most interesting things about Apophis's approach is the following. NASA's OSIRIS-REx spacecraft has the potential to blast a hole in the asteroid Apophis. Currently on its way back to Earth, the spacecraft completed a brief landing on the surface of Bennu in 2020. Its mission was to scoop up samples that may aid scientists in understanding the origin of Earth's water and life. After delivering its capsule of samples in 2023, the spacecraft will still have a surplus of fuel left over. This led its mission team to wonder, could it go somewhere else? It turns out that the spacecraft could reach Apophis. Michael Nolan, the science team chief on the mission from the University of Arizona, was pretty excited to announce that they would be able to allocate the spacecraft towards the asteroid at the fall meeting of the American Geophysical Union in New Orleans. By lucky coincidence, three flybys of Earth following the sample drop-off would lead the spacecraft to Apophis. When the asteroid passes through our skies in 2029, OSIRIS-REx would be just an hour behind, ready to approach the asteroid. The data and specimens collected from this asteroid would be highly valuable to scientists and space researchers. Although this may seem like a daunting task, Nolan has expressed his confidence in the spacecraft's abilities and the success of the mission. While this mission was not the original goal for the OSIRIS-REx spacecraft, it highlights the ingenuity and adaptability of NASA and its scientists. The potential to reach and study Apophis is a unique opportunity that could provide us with new knowledge and insights into the mysteries of our universe. Orbit determination and impact prediction. So how do we know all of these things? How are we even able to predict the coming of an asteroid? And how can we be confident enough to say a particular object will not hit Earth for at least a century? It's all a matter of physics and math, but you can think of it like playing a game of pool. You hit the cue ball and watch it bounce around the table, hitting other balls and bouncing off the walls. Now imagine you contract the path of every ball on the table, even as they continue to bounce around. That's essentially what we do with asteroids in space. Astronomers use telescopes to observe the position of an asteroid over time, and with some fancy math, calculus to be specific, they can calculate the asteroid's speed and trajectory. This allows them to determine the asteroid's orbit around the Sun and predict where it will be in the future. Now, predicting an asteroid's impact is a bit trickier. It's like playing a game of pool, but the cue ball is moving at 100,000 miles per hour and the table is constantly changing shape. But thanks to some impressive computer modeling, astronomers are able to simulate the movements of asteroids and their potential collisions with the Earth. So how do they protect us from these collisions? Well, it's like a game of dodgeball. Astronomers track the orbit of an asteroid and can't predict if it's going to cross paths with Earth. If it is, they have a few options. They can either try to deflect the asteroid's path by nudging it with a spacecraft, just like NASA did with the DART mission, or they can't evacuate the area where it's predicted to hit. In the end, it's all about using science and technology to stay one step ahead of the game and prevent any unwanted surprises from sneaking up on us. Before ending the video, here's a quick recap for you. The asteroid Apophis, discovered in 2004, won't hit the Earth in 2029, but it will pass very close to our planet. We will be able to see it with the naked eye from Europe and Africa, and we could use some clever solutions to study it a bit better. In particular, NASA already has some plans. This will lead us to a better understanding of the formation of our solar system and our place in it. Asteroid Apophis will probably change your plans for 2029.